Spouse of intimacy anorexia, that's our topic, and if that's in your life, you want to spend a few minutes and watch this. Intimacy anorexia is real. If you've never heard that term, Google it. Go to intimacyanorexia.com. Lots of information. Here's the basics. Intimacy anorexia is the active withholding of spiritual, emotional, and sexual intimacy from your spouse. So if you're the spouse watching this, you're the person who feels married and alone. If you're the intimacy anorexic, please keep watching. The characteristics of intimacy anorexia: staying too busy for your spouse, blaming your spouse, withholding love from your spouse, withholding sex, withholding spiritually, withholding emotionally, having anger or silence, using criticism ongoingly, okay? Some people control and shame around money issues, but you feel married and alone. You feel like a roommate. If you are experiencing this, you're the spouse of intimacy anorexic, okay? And your pain is real. If you go to partnerbetrayal.org, you will find lots of resources. We did a research that showed whether someone experienced infidelity, sex addiction, or being married to an intimacy anorexic, the trauma is exactly the same. You're experiencing PTSD. You're having flashbacks and thoughts and dreams. You're feeling more isolated. You don't feel like yourself. Depression would be common. Depression would impact you sexually. It would impact your energy. It would impact your sleep, your weight. Those are all normal. Your body's been impacted by the neglect of a spiritual and emotional neglect. And maybe you're not even having sex. Maybe it's been months or years since you've had sex. Intimacy anorexia may be why, okay? And if that's part of it, find out there. There's also a DVD called Sexless and Married. That can really help you as well, because it might be other factors. But if you're experiencing intimacy anorexia in your home, there's help for you. Now, you cannot make the other person get better. Okay, now they can find the information, and yes, couples heal. I've helped thousands and thousands of men and women heal from intimacy anorexia. I've done a training for professionals on intimacy anorexia. It's like over 30 DVDs. We see people get better in other cultures. It's a real situation that you are living with, and your pain is real, but only you can take next steps. So you might want to get the book, Partner Betrayal Trauma. You might want to get in a group. You might want to talk to a therapist who's really been trained in the spouse aspects of intimacy anorexia. You do deserve some help. Now, if you're new to our videos, please subscribe. Go ahead, and we got lots of other information out there that you could get access to. We put new stuff out all the time, and we'll alert you to that. But if you're married and alone, you're in a relationship with an intimacy anorexic, you might have some questions. Well, if you just put it in the comment section below, I will get back to you as soon as I can, and I'll personally write you a response. So if you're a spouse of intimacy anorexic, I want to first say it's not your fault. You're not to blame. You're not responsible. But you are responsible to start moving towards healing for yourself. So please do that.